Also, I want to thanks to organizer to give us the possibility to present some of our work in Faculty of Medical Bioengineering, where we are doing different studies and different topics on biomaterials and tissue engineering, especially in scaffolding different polymers or composites based on natural and synthetic polymers for tissue engineering. Today, our presentation is very close to regenerative medicine and the need of this topic to prepare different types of biomaterials with 3D structure in aim to assimilate some cells or to create some bioartificial networks, and in this way to assist some soft or hard tissues which are damaged by diseases, by trauma, or because of some congenital issue. When we are discussing about scaffolds, we have to take in consideration some properties of such scaffolds, starting with their physical and chemical properties, their morphology, also some characteristics which are very important from application point of view, like biocompatibility, like the possibility to host some cells to be or not to be biodegradable in the human body, to be to connect to the surrounding tissues, also to retain some biological fluids and to have mechanical properties which make them appropriate for one or another application. Sometimes we need to put some drugs inside of the scaffold, and in this way to enlarge the application of the scaffold. Various scaffolds have been tested in this field, starting from natural materials or artificial materials, synthetic materials or composites between this kind of materials, and scaffolds for various tissues like skin, like cartilage, bone, or heart tissue have been proposed. Each of such the scaffold has to complete some properties and to have some morphology with which make them very good for one or another tissue. For example, for soft tissue, we need some types of properties, but for hard tissues, we need to take in consideration more mechanical properties or the response of such scaffold to the biological system. In our work from today, we will discuss only some scaffolds for soft tissue engineering, and more exactly some scaffolds which are proposed to be used in the skin tissue engineering, and even to work as wound dressing material or to be a scaffold for preparing a skin substitute. The traditional method to treat such wounds in skin has some drawbacks, like pharmacological agents has some side effects, or some dressing if have some hydration problems, has some induce some pain, and some skin substitutes have to be very well prepared and very clean condition to remove any risk of infection, or to not induce some immune response from the body. From this point of view, various natural polymers like collagen, hyaluronic acid, chitosan, or chondroitin sulfate, or synthetic materials have been tested. I have to pass each slide, but I think it's better. Sorry for this missing. I will continue my presentation from here, because I told before that different natural material like collagen, hyaluronic acid, chitosan or chondroitin sulfate, synthetic materials like polyepsilon caprolactone, polysiloxane or polyurethane have been tested as materials for such scaffolds. In this context, our objective was to prepare hydrogel starting from collagen, because we try to improve the capability of the collagen to be more resistant in the scaffold, knowing the fact that collagen is very easily degraded by proteolytic enzymes, and some scaffolds are not very good from this point of view. So our strategy was to prepare hydrogels, modifying collagen and mixing the collagen with hyaluronic acid, with two types of hyaluronic acids, one also modified and another one pure hyaluronic acid. So we didn't do the modification of the chitosan. We obtained some collagen. We obtained the collagen, modified collagen from a selling company, which prepares some pure collagen, which is used usually in bioprinting. And we did the modification only to the hyaluronic acid, using a simple method, which can produce some modification with double bonds on the hyaluronic acid, and in this way to prepare practically the compounds which are able to be connected together. We can see here the collagen is modified at the amine groups, and here the hyaluronic acid is modified to hydroxylic groups. We did mixtures between those two polymers, and we tried to prepare networks with very good properties by changing the ratios between collagen and hyaluronic acid, even the hyaluronic acid was modified or not. After preparing the mixture, we added the initiator for the reactions between groups present on the both polymers, and we exposed the mixture to UV radiation at 365 nanometers for 10 minutes. And after that, we purified the network, and we dried them by freeze drying. And we can see here the structures. We can here a structure which is formed between when both polymer are modifying, and we can see here connections between both polymers. And here, when hyaluronic acid was not modified, we can see here that we have a network of collagen which include inside the free hyaluronic acid molecules. The next step was to characterize and to demonstrate that reaction was produced. And we did analysis in EFTIR spectroscopy on dry hydrogels. And the groups which are associated with amine A, amide 1, 2, were present on the both networks. Even they were very very long term purified. This means that both polymers have been reacted and a three dimensional network have been obtained. Some groups, some peaks associated with the modifying groups are also present, indicating that all components are present in the 3D network. The next step was to analyze the morphology of the hydrogels, and we did some scanning electron microscopy tests. And if we are comparing the materials which are prepared with modified hyaluronic acid and unmodified, we can see that their structure are quite different. When we have a very interconnected network, we can see here a more fibrillar structure, which is explained by the possibility of the polymer to be close, to be together, and in this way to form more associated 3D structure. The network with unmodified hyaluronic acid, we can see a more uniform 3D network, but with a smaller size of the pores, and this characteristic should be a problem when we are including the interaction with cell. Another test was to evaluate the swelling properties in two different media. We tested the materials in phosphate buffering solution, and also in wound simulated fluids. Both type of simulated components giving us some information about how such materials will perform when they are coming in contact with wound skin. What we can observe there is the fact that all hydrogels are very easy swellable. More exactly, after 50 minutes, the equilibrium is already reached. And also, such hydrogels have a very high swelling degree. We can observe here even 50,000 percent degree of swelling for the networks which are prepared with both polymer modified. Also, we did some experiments regarding the bioadhesion of the materials. And from this point of view, we try to understand if such scaffold can be used as wound dressing materials, and if we can apply the scaffolds on the wound. And we did some experiments on a texture analyzer, which has an adhesion modulus. In such modulus, we can put in contact the scaffold with tissue or a membrane, which simulate the biological media. And after that, we maintain in contact the sample with the membrane. And after time, we remove the sample and we measure the force which is necessary to remove this contact. So we can obtain graph, which means force in time. And from this graph, we can identify the force of adhesion and also to calculate the work of adhesion, which give us information if such materials are important from point of view of the interaction with biological media. We can see here our graph, one example for mixture between between collagen and hyaluronic acid, which was prepared as a 3D structure. But and here the force of adhesion and the work of adhesion for all materials prepared in our study. What we can observe from this data? We can observe that by adding hyaluronic acid, the adhesion properties are decreasing. But I have to tell that the values are included in the domain, which are considered to be good for all materials which are applied as wound dressing materials. So this means that we have to be very careful with the content of hyaluronic acid, which is added in our components. The next step was to evaluate the degradation of the materials, and the tests have been done in incubation media, which contain collagenase, which is a specific enzyme for collagen. And the degradation was evaluated in time by measuring the product of degradation. And they were evaluated by reaction with anhydrin and the absorbance of the product was evaluated spectrophotometrically. What we can see also here, we can observe that as was expected, the materials with a higher content of collagen are easier degraded. And but what was more important was the demonstration of the possibility to decrease this degradation rate by adding modified hyaluronic acid, because we can see here by comparing materials with modified hyaluronic acid, we can modify the concentration of the materials which is removed from the scaffold. The final test in this study, because we have to do more to evaluate their property, was a cytotoxicity test, which was evaluated by on fibroblasts from albino rabbit, and the entity assay was used in the aim to measure the cell viability. And we can see here comparing two materials with the same composition, but with modified hyaluronic acid and non-modified hyaluronic acid, that the cell viability is has values more than 95%, and very close to control. And in some and at some times of testing, we can see higher values that indicate somehow that such materials could improve the could induce the cell proliferation. To evaluate the cell morphology, and like that staining assay has been performed. So the cells were first fixed with formic aldehyde for 24 hours, and finally stained with Maigre-Grignard GEMSA reactive. And we can see here, comparing with control, for example, for the materials which included modified hyaluronic acid, that the morphology of the cells is not modified, but also the number of cells are higher, indicating that such materials could be appropriate in in interaction with fibroblasts. So finally, we can conclude that by using a method of cross-linking with the double bonds on which were fixed on collagen and hyaluronic acid, we can obtain very high swellable hydrogel, both in PBS and also in simulated wound fluids. Also, such hydrogel are bioadhesive and are degradable, and the degradation is very high dependent on the content of hyaluronic acid and the nature of the modification of the hyaluronic acid. And such hydrogels are cytocompatible, which is an indication that can be used as scaffolds for the population, for example, with cells. We have to do more tests regarding the mechanical properties of the hydrogels and to correlate the mechanical properties with the manipulation of the hydrogels. And also to do more tests and in vivo tests to confirm that such materials are able to stimulate the regenerative processes which are happening in the tissue, more exactly in skin tissue. Finally, I want to thanks to the project who give us money for this study, and to organizer for the possibility to present some of our work in this conference. And I'm waiting some questions if they are.
Thank you very much for very interesting presentation and useful presentation. These questions, maybe the audience has some questions.
If not, they can write me in private and we will answer with pleasure.
I have a short question. What kind of techniques do you suppose to use for hydrogel populations with cells?
I think that will be enough. We are discussing different techniques at the moment. But I think that to put together hydrogels with cells in first in a static condition, but after that in dynamic condition would be a possibility. Not to prepare the cells before and after that to not to prepare before the layers of cells, but to put together the cells to grow up in the presence of the hydrogel. We will test different methods.
Okay, thank you very much.